been working over in Spalo. I'm a researcher in the medical center, which is called Eureka. Computational social science, which is like a mixture of answer to social questions through artificial intelligence and supported by computer mediation. And for that, instead of continuing with the theory of that, I think it's much easier to provide some examples. And the first example of citizen participation that I will explain is based on Twitter. And in particular, the campaign of the local elections of 2015. Well, the motivation for this study was done in the aftermath of the Data Rights Victim Network and supported by this project is that several observations. The first observation of the latest study was the organization of social movements. Maybe some of you will be familiar with Manuel Castells and his ideas of more social movements, when he was talking about the concept of the social movements. These movements are a network also in multiple forms, like online networks, offline networks, and also across platforms. And this idea of talking about networks, because these movements claim to have a central node and have a decentralized structure. This is similar to another study this idea by Lance Bennett and Zuckerberg, where they were talking that these new movements were characterized by a change from a collective action to a connected function, because they were working as networks. Well, these were theoretical ideas, and when we observe those networks on Twitter, because this is the fifth event on Twitter during the first day in a study, also another study with similar data, similar analysis, we truly observe that those movements, or in this case, the fifth event, had a decentralized structure based on the coalition of small organizations. And also when we analyzed those networks of the 50 men, it was certainly decentralized. They were not leaders or stakeholder executives. This is the first observation. The second observation of the latest study is the organization of political parties. Like in political science, which is the Iron Law of Oligarchy by Robert Mitchell in 1950, where he says that political parties, any complex organization, at some point will self-generate an elite. Okay, and to say organizations say oligarchy. Like in complex organization, in particular political parties, there's always going to be an elite ruling the organization. And this is the base in political studies of elite theory that says that the small minorities, the elites, will have that power in most political processes, and several studies like Pareto and Oscar Mills have proved that. And this is from political theory, but when we analyze political networks on Twitter, and this is the Spanish election of 2011 at the same time of the FIFA movement, in December 2011, yeah, what we observed was also with the same methodology, like in the tweet networks on Twitter of political parties, and in comparison to the FIFA, we observed that parties belong to particular clusters, totally isolated. They are competing among themselves, it's not like citizens that they share across networks the flow. Also, what we found more interesting is like all of these clusters, the network structures, the network matrix, they were extremely centralized around the account of the candidate or the account of the party. This is the process one of the Esquerra Republicana de Catalunya. And the third motivation was of observation that in this election, in the local election of 2015, there were emerging parties, grassroots parties, that came from some areas of the fiscal movement. And most of these parties now are ruling the several cities in Spain, like Barcelona Común, Alameda Madrid, Zaragoza Común, María del Ángel Galicia, Compostela Venta, Organización Puente, Cuatro Madalona. This provides some kind of research question, okay? So if we assume that in that case, we were based in Barcelona, so we're focused on Barcelona, like Barcelona Común emerged from the 50-year movement, and the 50-year movement was characterized by a decentralized structure, what would happen in Barcelona Común? We'd keep a decentralized structure, as the movement how it was, we develop a centralized structure, a same political party, because now they move to those practices. For that, we apply the same methodology as before, like detect, build a network of all the parties, trying to detect the different communities, and also characterize the structure of these communities, of these networks. So we build a data set, and the data set is all the retweets from the tweets that we obtain by a list of users, like the party account and the candidate account of all the parties that went through the election. And we got this huge network, so huge that 6,000 nodes and 16,000 links. Well, this is a bit technical. It was quite important for a study. Like, first of all, we use the same algorithm we were using before, which is called the main method, which is the one that is using Gephi, a tool that Google explored after the Warsaw. And what we found is like there were 8 clusters for 7 parties. And every cluster, at some point, they have media accounts in the middle. And we also tried to analyze the echo network of those accounts, like in this case, it's the local TV, and this is our private media. And we are good service like media was building ties between communities. So for us, it was hard to analyze the structure of the party if they were in the middle. And also because, for example, the public media, they were retweeted by every cluster at some point because they celebrated a debate, so they create content for everybody. But for example, here, the parties Catalonia, they create party that was also retweeted by WhatsApp. Or the independent media like Aria or Digital, they were mostly retweeted by nationalistic. So we observed that public TV was forced to be plural, while private media were retweeted by like-minded parties. So for us, that was a problem because if we wanted to analyze the structures of the reporting on the media inside, it was going to be hard. And also some point for some technical reason that I can explain after, if we have this situation that media is not in the center, mathematically with the algorithm, it can belong to the blue cluster, to the blue network. And mathematically, if we execute the algorithm another time, it can be red, or it can be green, or it can be white. Mathematically there is a distribution for that. Depends on the algorithm. So for trying to solve that, what we did is like running the algorithm several times until it gets stable, and for 100 times was enough, and just consider for every cluster the nodes that truly appear more than 95% of the times inside of the cluster. Okay. Are you following? So we did that, and what we observed was first like a constant presence of the 8 clusters. One execution, but there are only 7 parties. What we observed like now with this new algorithm, like media was out, like those gray nodes are the media, so sometimes they were appearing one cluster or another, now they're out because they don't appear all the time in the same one, so we remove them. And what we found is like there was a cluster for every party, like this is the Ciudadans, PP, well, the Conservatives, the Socialists. Independent, for Barcelona to move the party that was coming from the 15 movement, there were 2 clusters. Okay? 2 big ones. And what we observed in the data, what we found is this. Like they were, that cluster upstairs, mathematically they say there was 1 cluster, but we observed like that cluster was like stars. In the center was Barcelona to move the party, Ada Colau, a great mayor and candidate. Growing parties like Podemos or Madrid. And it was really centralized. We observed like there was like stars, like a main node with some small nodes retreating existence. Well, here we saw another network that seems much more decentralized, more denser, much more clustered, and totally different. So, okay, now we have like the 8 clusters, the 7 parties, because Barcelona Group has 2 clusters, 1 of the party and 1 of the movement. So, in the structure of analyzing, and when we analyze it, we use a framework of previous studies, this is technical. What we did Are you familiar with Gini coefficient? Okay, Gini coefficient is a metric of economy that is based to understand the inequality of income. Okay? So it's like a metric for trying to understand if the income of the population in a country is more equal or more unequal. And normally, as closest to the diagram, is more equal. Okay? So we try to understand how was the hierarchical structure of the parties. And the income of the parties was the number of retweets. So if the number of retweets was distributed among the users of the party, it was centralized for just some specific parties. We would compute that the before is like the party participant was strongly centralized, but the movement was then less centralized than the rest of the parties. Also, some of you may be familiar with the small global networks, like say the social networks by definition, like it's very easy to go from one node to another node in less than 6 steps because the social networks are very elastic. This is because, as Martin mentioned, which is called the clustering coefficient. This is mainly because the friends of my friends are also, two of my friends are also friends. That's the reason why I'm also working. So the properties, and what we found is like, again, Barcelona, the party was very, very centralized. It was like not very bonded, not clustering. What the movement was the one who received more, the highest small world property. And in the middle, the rest of the parties. Okay, so we observed like the movement was all the most centralized. And in every metric, the party was the most centralized. And in the middle, as a benchmark, the rest of the parties. And finally, we use another metric, which is called the equal composition, that is a metric kind of resilience. At some points, we are extracting nodes. We have this network, we remove all the nodes that have one green. Like these the blue ones. We remove the blue ones, the rest of the nodes have at least two connections with nodes with two connections. So we go to the second layer and we remove all the ones. And finally, the third layer, we remove all those four nodes that are going to have three nodes with three connections. So this is like picking a network and trying to see how resilient it is that network. And when we did that in every cluster, what we found again is that the party was going to move because the candidate, the party was not very resilient between 1 and 5 levels. The rest of the party is between 1 and 11. But the movement of Barcelona move was the most resilient one because it was very clustered, so it's very hard to remove all the stuff. That's right. So we had a research question, what was going to happen with Barcelona move, if it was going to be decentralized as a part, decentralized as a movement, and what we found was like there was a dual part, like there was a party cluster, like this one, like very centralized and not very resilient, but a movement cluster, very decentralized and very resilient. We also got, there was like some kind of polarization, as we said in the previous campaign, like the parties were very separated, but also what analysis at some point was something that was accentuated that effect. And also the thing with media, like when we observed that like, the public TV was more corrupt, maybe because by law in Barcelona they were forced to make a debate, so they were creating content that at some point every cluster was able to retweet. While private media, they were mostly retweeted by parties that were similar to the ideology or ideas of that media outfit. And well, from that we have some former research question. Was because it's a confluence of movements and parties, or is because the 50 men, they have the backend, the centralized backend system, and they just build a front-end part, like an interface, to seem like a party, but in the core, then it's still like a movie. Someone would love to continue this study with other similar scenarios, like our Madrid, and Open, even out of Spain, like CISA, as well as networks. In this case, it was Twitter, but why not on Facebook or YouTube or Instagram? And this was the first study, like how political participation occurred in a minor social network as Twitter. This second study is Meñane. I don't know if you are familiar with Meñane. many of these tools, the discussion, like the discussion dynamics, the possibility of chatting or interacting verbally with other users, are one of the most important features of those platforms. Okay, we're talking about the platform society, but also it's interesting to talk about the platform democracy. Also, this program, I think, is perfect because the main objective of this few weeks is how to build platforms that can contribute to better democracy systems. As I said here, like, there are many new tools. Hopefully, after this hackathon of 2 weeks, they will be a bit more, or the versions of existing ones. As I said before, still many of these platforms incorporate discussion in order to promote and interactive process of democracy. And I think my example is an example of how deliberation is important for platforms. Also, collaborative hunting with Pablo, I think about that. But we have been analyzing platform in the past, or platform that we have been checking in several processes. What we found is that platforms can have different ways of presenting conversations. This is our minister in Finland, in which the conversation is so hierarchical, or like threads. Like comments are so following the thread structure. Like this is a comment, a comment, to the previous comment, and visually I presented that information, like how the replies are being done. Another tool, this is true by said by Democracy OS, is more linear. Actually, this is not fully true because Democracy OS is like hybrid because they have two levels of indentation. So it's linear but of two levels. What this example is done in Barcelona, we can say that people are commenting, and are commenting to the post. They appear all together linearly, sometimes sorted by ranking, sorted by type. And also, the comments to the comments also they can be sorted in other way. And we'll go there. Okay, there are different types of presenting information. Which interface? Does it matter? It's just peaceful? It's just a technical decision? Or it has political or social impact on that? Well, we did this by, first of all, check the state of the art. Check what other studies were saying. We found one of my colleagues in 2011 that they were saying like the threaded view, the hierarchical view in online forums are very effective to build communities in comparison to just traditional talk. This is for online forums, also there were some studies in chats, and there's a study by Coops in 2016 that said that the hierarchical view in a chat platform was very useful to solve the context loss problem. The context loss problem is the possibility of a user to understand the coherence of the conversation. Like when it's treated, they were observing that user were more able to follow the discussion while in comparison to just a chat. Like that. And it was similar to the speed falling with us in 2000, that coherence was much more visible, but also users were rating worse because they said, okay, we understand better, but it's not very functional. Results are similar, like in events, it's the same for the local context in the hierarchical, but we can say that the linear is the most effective one. And also for this platform, like even for open social networks like Facebook or Twitter, like Facebook sent the fully linear interface to the hybrid, like democracy, like comments to the post, but also comments to the comments on one level. And also Twitter regularly replies. Right now, we can see a reply, a reply, a reply, and there is no analysis on that. So, because of this review, the state of the art, what we found is well, the presentation matters at some point. The few studies that were comparing both interfaces were just experiments with some groups of people, but not with a real platform, with a real community. This is exactly what we did, and this is the one of the reasons why we chose the game. When MSS Men is like a new job, it was very popular, especially after 2000. It was already popular, but with the 50 men, it became very popular as alternative media. It was one of the main channels for one very relevant channel for discussing about social movements and political discussion. this comment will be a comment to the third one, to set it specifically, but the interface of the data. But in January 2015, they decided to talk to people and to change the soil reference. So that leads us to some research questions. The first one, how are the structure of the discussion affected by using a linear and using a hierarchy? Which parameters of user behavior can explain those changes? And finally, which kind of view, the linear or the hierarchical, is more effective in order to promote deliberation and community building. So, what we did again, we took all the data from 2015 to 2015, back years, with all these thousands of threads and aggregate comments, and see what like, the stories were going down. It was very popular on the Brazilian page. Maybe 2015 was in the movement. The comments were going down and down, but not rising up. And the signal from the user that they remain stable. And also, you can see that it's a seasonal pattern, like there's a lot of activity during the years, therefore, holidays. And as I say, it was very important for the 15 movement. One of the proofs for that is that these are all the days in all these years, and how many stories there were on those days, and how many goals to the stories there were on those days. Some days the platform is overloaded, and those days are days that the days of the Palace, the days where the parliament was corrupted, the thing was said by the Congress, or with some similar strikes like Peoria Valenciana, a strike of the Asturian leaders. So, certainly, it was true that it was very active during the 15th movement, but we were interested in the discussion. So, what we found. Trying to observe different discussions. It's a discussion, so the center is the post, like the first comment, and then there is a comment, that they receive a comment or receive two comments. Do you understand why this is a discussion? Correct? Okay, so what we observe like in the linear view, most discussions look like this. That there was the root, like the post, and many people directly commented there, and sometimes some lines which are like two users. Well, here, in 2015, the structure changed. And sometimes, some comments bring some cascades. Like for example, this big comment you said, sometimes there is a comment that makes like several branches or several discussions. So some discussions are appearing. And that's what we found from the exploration. This is mathematical in advance, so we have to issue that. And for issuing that, it's related to comment deliberation. There is a study from Santa Marta de Bailón and some colleagues in 2010 that says that on deliberation, based on a model of Ackermann and Fiskin, it can be considered like a mixture of two dimensions, argumentation and representation. So deliberation occurs where there is a lot of representation and a lot of argumentation. So what we propose like discussion threads.
Are you following me?
Quarto Técnico. And also for community building, one of the observatory studies have tried to propose that community is one of the main features for a community to really do to have creative practices, like the reciprocal aspect of conversation. Users are really interacting with each other and they are doing mutual interactions. So we just use a reciprocity method and try to use the network. We did the work and explain to Jason who is interested how reciprocal the interaction that we did with. And okay, we have two metrics, one for the duration, the reciprocity for community building, and how to measure the things. So in econometrics, there is a technique called regressionist community design. And it has been recently used by many actually this year for analyzing this specific thing, which is platform effects, and how a change in a platform can create a different kind of behavior. So the idea of platform effects is that you just have two dimensions, you make an intervention here, and this is the control group, this is the experimental one, and when it finishes after the intervention, you measure the break. So for our platform effect, here is time, like the control group is before the change, the experimental group is after the change, and we just measure the difference between them. We did that, we found that. Like, this, actually we had set the duration statistically, it was found that when the platform, the visual conversation was changed statistically, that was the best place for doing the discontinuity. And we also said that the age index and the duration was going like this. After the change, it jumped and also changed even the slow. And similar to the way the rest of the process was like this, and when they change the interface, it went like that. Okay? And this is quite cool, but we wanted to understand. So this is even more complicated. This is a model of artificial intelligence to try to understand how conversations work. So at some point, this model, what we want to do is that imagine that we have that discussion with nine comments, and we want to put a new comment. So what we are trying to optimize is which feature is more attractive for that comment to arrive to the third, to be arrived to the one, to the second, or to the sixth. Okay? So for that, we use three metrics, the very model of six comments, which the first one is the popularity, or the referential attachment. It's a model by and what is said that the notes, the comments that they have many replies will be more attractive than the ones that have fewer replies. Okay? The second is like the root bias, like there must be a difference between the post and the recent comments. And the users will at some point make a distinction, just comment the regular idea, the post, or one of the comments. Then the novelty, which is an activity factor, try to explain comments gradually become less attractive, so at some point it will be more attractive than new ones. And finally, because of our first findings, we add the reciprocity. Like if the 10th comment is written by user A and 6 is the user B, he's going to reply to someone who has replied to you, but we have not saying that we have said. Okay? So, after we post my comment, the best place that discussion is going to comment is the place that someone is commenting to me. We apply a model, we got the weight of this model of every of the features, and what we said is that all of them suffer that same. The popularity was much better than now. Popular comments are even more popular, but statistically for the bias is not so significant. For the novelty decay, it goes up, which also means that now all comments become more popular. And also there is a process. Like now we're in the phase. Similar characterization of interactions is even more important. Yeah?
What do you think that that's the same
linked to the critical approach to deliberation. Of course, deliberation has been focused also on the lessons that we are learning here, and also on the school. And why is the reason? Well, because as we observe, now this new interface promotes more the simple interactions, also make like popular comments, which we are also the first ones to get more popular, more popular, more popular. That makes that also those old comments still visible because they are here at the beginning and the main space. So, according to those metrics, my group went in continue what I was saying before. Software can be like more deliberative and specific structures. This is interesting because how people are not just discussing between just replying to the root as we thought interacting with them, or not only text to people, but there are real discussions. But at some point, discussions appear with the first branches. So, imagine like a very long conversation and nothing. That already has several metrics. If you don't post a comment in the first branch, it will go to the end. It will be easy. For someone can get it, but it's not easy to follow that. So at some point, that's quite traumatic if you want to bring innovation to large debate. Like if there's a debate for several with this discussion process. So there's this pros, but of course, there are those comments. That's what. Would be interested how to sort these branches. Like for example, now in the city of Madrid, possibly probably in Barcelona, as far as I'm concerned, the found sorting of branches is the number of walls. The most popular are the correct. So at some point, it solved that problem, but there is the same problem in the end, because the most potent one was obviously the first walls, go to the first position. We are the most visible, still more balls, still in the first position, so it's very hard for a large discussion to bring these ideas and get this. As I was saying, we were using and trying to talk about deliberation in terms of the structure of the discussion and how these networks are, but there are also messages. So at some point, we would like to analyze the content of the message to see if yes, some discussion, but it really talks about the deliberative process. Comprehensive type of discussion as Fiske proposed, or they have Habermas approach, or they have several schools of deliberation. This is the terms the idea that I wanted to bring here is that this was similar, like a technical decision, this is an interface, but it has dramatic social consequences. As always, many of the decisions we will take for your platforms will imply some effects in terms of even political behavior within the platform. So it's interesting to have to analyze what's happening before and after the scenes. So before moving like to the pure city grant platforms of City Hall and Square, is there any question?
Are you sitting? Are you happy?
Okay. So let's move on for the first platform. Participation, we're going to talk about the theme of Madrid, but many of you with your research of your projects have analyzed the theme of Madrid as the first one of the main console instances. And we'll get the story of the theme of Madrid from September 2015, the City Hall of Madrid, since the new portal of open government, public participation, transparency, and open data, and public participation was the theme of Madrid, the space where people or citizens were invited to discuss and set the city model for debates, proposals, patents, also sectoral processes. You'll know this, like debates are like discussion first, or by a citizen, or proposals are also the discussion first, but people can decide the discussion. If support, or when the support reaches the 1% of the census of Madrid, they will rotation yes or no, and it will be a election. 2 months or skills that analysis and visualization. As of one idea, the idea is part of the Jaguar and it's called what they call hacking process, and how we experiment with the tool and the platform to try to provide some guidelines and all us out. And for that analysis, this is what we were analyzing here. Really segregated, how our idea is affecting different tracking behavior was able to build like taxa categories, the super categories. So it was something to see like fog surveys, which is like a survey being like crossed by fogs, were appearing. Then we move to the life cycle of proposals, and this is what we was in November. Here and here, the proposal that we're proposing that day, the level that they reached in November. Like they were green, they were between 0 and 100 supports. If they are, if it's yellow, it's like this, the proposals in that day between 100 supports and 1,000. Red for other 1,000 supports. And what we observed is like the red ones were most of the ones at the beginning. Actually, there were 2 months. That one is rolled in the next, the following months were published in the first days of the platform, which the implementation was happening. The only exception to that was those first ones here, which was an issue coming in Madrid, because I said that the manual was going to solve with the Belenes, and there were like some proposals about that, with a lot of media attention, which was a little bit easier to promote that. So at some point, this is interesting for trying to understand. With the current model in the same way, the difficulty of a proposal to grow over time, because I thought the proposals are presented kind of related. So it's hard to list a 1% of the census. And actually, it's one of the ideas that is expected to be followed by the next step of beta learning, how to analyze the proposal that you're going to grow over time. Otherwise, after 2 days, then it reaches the level, it's going to be quite hard to get more possibilities. And also in terms of the users, we try to analyze what was the first interaction of a user when appearing in the platform for the first time. Well, we also like the main two, the rates were proposed, like 2 cents mostly were proposed in the debate or commenting on the debate, the same for proposals. One proposal was available, people didn't appear for the first time on the debate. Except here, which was the manuals, many people really turn the platform for trying to discuss with Manuel Camena. And also, a very interesting thing at least for me was that I hear what proposals were promoted. When proposals were promoted, there was like some kind of balance between people deciding to make a proposal or comment an existing one. Well, here in the closing campaign, as more people decided to build a new proposal, maybe an existing proposal in the platform I wasn't created, rather than commenting. And at some point, the fusion campaign, one of the examples, did design the value of Madrid. So there could be some kind of explanation. It would be interesting to make some kind of research with participants on the platform. If really that message affected the way of interacting, like they refer to go to the platform, make a proposal instead of reviewing the system one, and maybe providing feedback and opening a new proposal to the system. Our finance is the same model for Madrid. I tell that we observed like it was very rich in different kinds of debates in Madrid. I think this was a debate that from the graphics in Madrid was very small. This one is the one of four losses, the joint actions, and a lot of comments and a lot of saying that it was sorry, it was so stupid, so there was nothing to discuss it, and maybe no documentation. That one there, there is a lot of documentation and not so much representation. What you can see there is there was discussing about some issues related with the platform, so it was like very specific, so the users, no, sorry, yeah. So users were interested in that, just discussing between themselves, and they had said that nobody was doing it. And this was one of the most interesting ones, which was about making public some services of the system that were private, so the most frequent question. And finally, the case study, it was for the sister, one of the sisters of the city of Madrid, which is the city of Barcelona. And well, the city of Barcelona is like a platform for citizen participation in Barcelona, and it was launched by this city hall in the 1st of February of this year, mostly for one act. Now that's the process, and last time was for one process. And that process is because in Barcelona, when a new government appears, they have to define physical meetings where people were able to discuss the purpose of the platforms, or build new ones to the platforms that they lost from the games and the user plans. And as the table did, also we can support also their citizens and their users discussing also all the comments. So we analyze also the structure, kind of analyzing them because you have seen two minutes. We analyze the structure of the table lead.
This is true, but also those proposals were the part of the
presentation, the organization of this physical meetings. Also, my very thanks for it, because there were people discussing some points. They were much better than the one with the idea. As you can see, there's still more than 50% were accepted, but still not so good as organization of physical meetings where people gather together. And at some points, they made proposals with a higher level of openness. As I said, there were physical meetings appearing in the city. It's just a few months. I'm trying to see that I also have two attacks.
And then will write reports of these discussions. There'll also be a note of the minority views, so on why people disagreed on some points, to show that consensus was not actually achieved. And my question was, again, our deliberation, why did you choose Christian's thing as like how you were going to do the deliberation?
To try to understand and expect the community. sense of a platform, like the one in Miami Bay, or the uses of new platforms in city halls like the City Hall and the City Barcelona. Well, the world we realize it, but also we visualize it. One of the main ideas of going visual to the analysis is because the visualization of data is like a very effective way to try to balance also perception and cognition. You can think, but also you can see, so you can feel a balance to understand. Okay, it's quite technical. I can give you an idea. I don't know if you're familiar with the Ascom Quartet. The Ascom Quartet is yeah. different, and there are some other approaches, for example, the also app, and trying to provide that there's a more realistic perspective on the size of contracts. And also very interesting, if sometimes if you are mapping, it's interesting to enforce the idea that you are mapping. And it's a new CD, and it's just mapping. The users on their side, the subscribers to markets they are leaving, or the consumer of pornography. And they are the mapping that that's mapping for the population is the cost of the rest of the cost of the main cities. So sometimes that's very interesting, getting into the user absolute numbers, maybe the percentage of the comparison to the population, to really try to solve your idea of where something appears in a map. If that is so dependent on the size of the population, then you know it's all where the population lives in the country, at the end or so. And also related to some questions that have been done.
Some people in the group of
in terms of these ways and networks, one is Tata is Delphi, some of them are really in Warsaw. Before the Madrid, we were
Hawker and Navar that have been designed to facilitate more delivery of this style of description, but it's beyond just like the form, so it has different structures. It's been used for like online participatory budgeting as well, so if anyone's interested, I what's called Bang the Table? Bang the Table. And what's called our say, like our say. I think they're both Australian, but they use outside of Australia. And the online participatory budgeting is on yoursay.sa.gov.gov. I'll tell you later. The South Australian government does a lot of online deliveries and stuff. Okay, so Y O U R dot S A.
Eso, que si no, por la carga, se ignora que el interior captura esos tweets. muchas veces tenemos sesgo a los datos, aunque lógicamente la forma de analizarlos sea muy robusta, los resultados pueden ser significativos, al estar en la set sesgado, los resultados no son más incluyentes. ¿Por qué explico esto? Porque, por ejemplo, cuando se realizan datos históricos en Twitter, muchas veces muchos estudios que hay sobre partidos en Twitter lo que hacen es coger el hashtag del partido. Eso normalmente, por ejemplo, en el caso de España, es absolutamente inválido. Pues los partidos que tienen, como explicaba el estudio de aquí arriba, Yo espero que la vida de esta selección, al menos en un lado, es un poco compleja, mientras que cambie, pero si no, todavía es todo el tiempo. Decidí Barcelona, una persona con la propuesta, porque está en el mercado, la de la operadora de la selección municipal. Entonces, la gente que hace un comentario de primer nivel puede decir cuando comenta si es a favor, en contra o en contra. Entonces, si es en contra, le vas a ir contra abajo, si es a favor, en verde, y si es neutral, en gris. Y luego se puede votar tanto positivamente como negativamente. Entonces, lo que decía, básicamente, es que el número de votos es el tamaño de la vuelta. Lo de dentro indica si es positivo o a favor o neutral. De hecho, como solamente puede ser el primer nivel, todos esos de secundaria más no se llaman colores, pero no están polarizados. Y el de borde es verde si tiene más puntos a favor, rojo si tiene más puntos en contra, y si tiene empate o si tiene empate, se está variando. Yo no voy a aún así, es mejor, porque se está haciendo el empate a favor de los votos. Es más lo que se dice. De nuevo, siempre, principalmente, como funciona, cuando he ido a votar las propuestas, quizás a tú, me resolvía contar con el chat perfecto.
Thank you.
Bueno, pues con esto yo me despido.